Worcestershire lost their last 5 wickets for 38 runs as Kent claimed a final day victory in Canterbury. Worcestershire began the day on 213 for 6, needing 27 runs to make Kent bat again. The day didn't start well for the visitors, losing Cox in the second over, caught Treadwell off Coles for 39. Consecutive maidens followed, and the pressure told when Leach edged behind, chasing a wide one from Stevens for 3, Worcestershire 8 down and still 20 runs in arrears. Abbott struck a well-timed boundary to the mid-on fence, and Barnard followed his lead with a vintage cover drive. But the partnership was all too brief. Abbott, the victim of a smart piece of work behind the stumps from Billings, outstumped off the bowling of Stevens for 10. Barnard then went into T20 mode to get Worcestershire past 240 and into the red. But just 2 balls later, Barnard was to be the last man out, caught Gidman, bowled Stevens for 17. That left Kent with a target of just 12 runs to win, with Dixon and Bell Drummond requiring just 11 balls to get the job done. Kent the victors by 10 wickets in an impressive performance from the hosts. Claydon's 5 wicket haul in the first innings setting the tone for Kent, who piled up 451 in their first innings with a 75 run 10th wicket stand between Gidman and Claydon, taking the game away from Worcestershire. Plenty of batsmen got starts for Worcestershire in their second innings, but it was only Rhodes who was able to pass 50. Kent go to the top of Division 2, with Worcestershire in third, however Essex, in second, still have games in hand.